Hello everyone, my name is Kazuhito Yokoi from Hitachi. I'm very glad to be here today. As he explained, I am one of the contributors in open source Node-RED project. In my session, I'd like to explain about how to join open source community, open source software community. Let me start from what I will deliver in my presentation. At first, I will explain why open source software contribution is important activity in companies. Next, an open source software visual programming tool, it called Node-RED, which developed by IBM and Hitachi mainly. I will introduce about the software. And third, based on my own experience in joining Node-RED community, I will explain about contribution know-hows, especially for Japanese companies. Lastly, I want to introduce new open source project, Node Generator, which Hitachi started contributing to. Yes. Next is advantages of open source software. As you know, there are a lot of advantages of using open source software in a company. I think that user company has 4 points as follows. First is low cost and delivery speed. Everyone can download, easily download the open source software on the internet as free software. And secondly, reliable source code. Entire source code is available on the internet. So if there is an error in your system using open source software, engineers can investigate the source code and they can come up with their solutions. Third is long-term support without vendor lock-in. Vendor lock-in has sometimes a good point for both engineers and vendor, but if the vendor stops their product, engineers need to consider about how to migrate their software to others. So it is sometimes a problem. But if the system uses open source software, engineers don't need to face the problem. The fourth is standard technologies. For example, Docker, Kubernetes, Cloud Foundries are open source software on the internet. And these software have compatibility with other systems. So if you use the open source software, the system will have compatibility and easy to connect to other systems. And open source software contributor company has more advantages over user companies. First, companies can add new functionalities related to their business. In fact, there are a lot of requirements of software in the company. If the company becomes open source contributor company, they can customize their software by themselves. And companies can advertise their abilities to their customers. Usually, companies can reach their customers through their salespersons. On the other hand, if the company becomes a contributor company, they can reach their customers by online contribution activities. In fact, in my case, after we started our contribution on GitHub, a lot of requirements, there are a lot of requirements from customers. So it is good advertisement for companies. Lastly, engineers can learn development skills from community members. In traditional development style, engineers need to solve their problem inside the company. On the other hand, if in open source community, engineers can ask their question on the internet, and other engineers in other company help him or her. In my case, in my experience, I learned JavaScript coding method and GitHub procedures from community members. So for these reasons, I encouraged a lot of companies to be a contributor. Yes. In the slide, I'd like to explain about open source software, Node-RED. This is the screenshot of the flow editor. And on the left side, there are a lot of connectors. And engineers select the software, and he or she drags and drop the connector to the central workspace. And then they wire the connectors in the processing order, like this. And once clicking the deploy button, the flow will run immediately. Because of flow-based programming, it realizes quick development without coding. And in the Node-RED project, there are various connectors to add new functionalities. And last one is important. Node-RED software is open source software under Linux Foundation project. So it is very open project on the internet. This slide shows history of Node-RED. 4 years ago, Node-RED was developed by IBM UK and released in QCon London conference. After, as soon as the announcement was made, Node-RED beta version of IBM Cloud has Node-RED as the default catalog. Since the end of 2015, Node-RED was pre-installed on Raspberry Pi Linux OS. At the end of 2016, the management of Node-RED project moved to Linux Foundation project to be more open. And as shown in the line chart, the number of downloads has increased gradually. And currently, Node-RED downloaded 50,000 times per month. Let me talk about who uses Node-RED. Major company uses Node-RED in their productions. There are three types of the approaches. First is cloud services. AT&T, Cisco, Fujitsu, Google, Hitachi, IBM, and Siemens have their Node-RED environments on their cloud services. And second is connectors. Fujitsu, IBM, Microsoft, NEC, and Expert published their connectors to connect to their services. And the third is edge devices. Fujitsu, GE, Intel, NEC, Samsung, Siemens, and Toshiba have their own edge devices which bundled Node-RED. RED character means DevRelCon Speakers Conference, DevRelCon Speaker Conference Company, Speakers Company. So a lot of company uses Node-RED. Yes. Next slide is benefit of Node-RED. There are three reasons why I recommend Node-RED. First is rapid development for IoT applications. Using Node-RED, factory engineer can easily create their application within couple of hours, and the same development style in both cloud and edge is important because IoT application tend to use in both environment. And secondly, standard technologies in industry are IoT. Node-RED has essential IoT technologies like REST API, WebSocket, and MQTT protocols. And this next, as I said in the previous slide, a lot of standard edge devices pre-installed Node-RED as for the development environment. Lastly, open community. Currently, 80 contributors are developing Node-RED on GitHub, so you can join the community and you can suggest new functionality. And there are a lot of connectors, so you can add connectors to your environment to suit your needs. This slide shows Node-RED key features. In the typical IoT system, there are 7 key features about the Node-RED. First is edge analytics. As you know, edge devices have sensors and camera and microphone. Node-RED can retrieve the data from sensor devices, and Node-RED can filter or analyze the data. For example, OpenCV nodes, OpenCV connector can detect human faces from image data. And second and third are data collection and device control. Node-RED supports MQTT protocol, so Node-RED on cloud collect the sensor data and control edge devices. And fourth is dashboard. Using dashboard, Node-RED can visualize sensor data on your browser. And fifth is connection to data lake. Node-RED supports a lot of major databases like MySQL and PostgreSQL and MongoDB. So last one is connection to other systems. If the other systems have REST API, Node-RED can connect to the system. In the slide, let me talk about how much Hitachi has contributed to Node-RED project. In just 1 year, we have added over 200 commits and 20,000 lines of code to Node-RED project. As shown on the line chart, Hitachi follows IBM as the second biggest contributor company. When we decided to start our contribution activity, we encountered some problem, so I want to introduce about that. Problem was there are no chance to start open source activities. After we are considering, solution was face-to-face meeting with core developers. To create a relationship with core developers, Hitachi members visited the IBM UK office and had technical discussions. This picture is first one in the IBM UK office, very old historical office, and this is Snap with core developers. I'd like to talk about how to start a contribution. After the face-to-face meeting, we understood the technical side of Node-RED. However, we are not familiar with contribution procedures on GitHub because only few Hitachi members use GitHub. As the solution, we suggested on-site development activity with core developers, and Hitachi engineers worked in IBM UK office for 2 weeks to run contribution procedures. In the IBM UK office, we had a discussion and coding. Sometimes, as shown in the picture, we had dinner together. Next, how to continue to connect with developers. Continuous connection with developers in foreign countries is very important to continue to online development. Therefore, we hold a monthly teleconference with core developers, and recently we started bi-weekly teleconference with all developers in UK, Canada, the US, and Japan. On the other hand, to communicate with community members, we are using a discourse forum like this. On the forum, we always suggest new functionality have discussions before we submit our pull request. Next, how to establish presence in the community. I think that number of users important to be major open source software. To realize it, we published 5,000 industry book like that, and we gave presentation in the global conferences. These activities were very effective in publishing our presence in the community. Lastly, what is the best for the first contribution? In terms of Japanese companies, I recommend some contributions as the first step. First is documentation, because sometimes official documents don't have the latest information, and Japanese have abilities to write English document if they have a lot of time to write. And secondly, quality improvement. I think Japanese can concentrate on quality improvement by adding test cases and bug fix. And third is internationalization of the software. As you know, Japanese language tend to be used only in Japan. So therefore, in general, foreign engineers cannot translate into Japanese. So it is good point, contribution point for Japanese company. Actually, in the Node-RED project, our first step was Japanese translation. And if you change your browser language setting on your Node-RED environment, you can see another language on the flow editor. Finally, I will introduce new open source project which Hitachi is contributing to. It is Node Generator. This tool is under the Linux Foundation project. Using the tool, engineers can easily create their code, connectors from Swagger API definition or JavaScript code. You can see the following URL. In the project, to add new functionalities, we have open discussion using following tool. As you know, Slack is real-time discussion tool with community members. Currently, over 40 members joined the node generator channel. And to share our roadmap, we are using GitHub Kanban board like this. If you are interested in the project, please visit the website. Lastly, I have demo to show Node-RED, to explain about Node-RED. Let me demonstrate Node-RED. And Node-RED, in Node-RED key features, Node-RED can easily connect to REST API. To show the functionality, I will demonstrate a simple example to get location data from Space Station API, and Node-RED show the location data on the map. I have a demonstration video, so let me show the video. Okay, this is Node-RED flow editor, and then I drag and drop the inject node. Inject node have functionality to kick the flow. And second one is HTTP request node to connect to REST API. And in this procedures, intervally, the flow will be kicked. And I paste REST API endpoint like this. And green node is debug node, last one. It shows data on the sidebar like this. And you can see latitude and longitude value. And then to convert data format, I used the change node, yellow one. And then I wired the connectors. And then to convert the data, first one is that. And copy the data path, and I paste the data path there. And I do the same procedures like this. And finally, the red node, red world map node, require value name, so I used the timestamp for it. Okay. And then I click deploy button. The flow runs immediately. And then to show the world map, there is the link inside info tab. When we see the world map, hopefully there is pins on the map. It means where is the space station, like this. The number means how many points there is how many points on the map. As you can see on the map, there is a lot of pins like this. Okay. That's all. Thank you for listening. Have a nice day.